Well, Brad and Hermione have joined me at the desk now because it's time to meet our musical guest for tonight. You may recognise her as half of a very famous sibling duo, but of course she's a star in her own right. She is Julia Stone.
Angus and Julia Stone rocketed up the Australian charts with their hit song Big Jet Plane in 2010. Together, they've won 5 ARIA Awards, including Single of the Year and Album of the Year.
And I'm so happy that we're all together and we're celebrating.
The siblings rode a wave of success performing all over the world. But in 2011, they shelved plans for a third album to spend time on solo projects.
That happens all the time, and it has happened all the time with Angus and I. Like, sometimes we're in the middle of doing something and then we're like, oh, we don't do it anymore.
Earlier this year, Julia released her second solo album, By the Horns, which was put together in California, France, Australia and India. Julia has just announced a tour of churches and cathedrals around Australia in February.
And Julia Stone joins us now at the desk. Julia, good evening.
Good evening.
A lot of your fans regularly describe your voice as heavenly, which might make what you have planned for your next tour a little bit hard for some of them to take. You'll be touring the country playing exclusively in cathedrals and churches.
Yeah, it's going to be nice.
They do it a lot over in Europe because there's so many cathedrals there, so this will be nice to do in Australia.
Mm. Be great.
What does it mean sort of acoustically as well, that opportunity to play in those old and very special places?
I guess churches, the way that they've been built, are really just great for the acoustics of voices, you know, and so many choirs, I guess, have sung in churches over time. And for the music that I write, I find that whenever I perform in a church, it's like, I don't know, I guess you just hear your voice travel around the room, the way that the building is. It's
beautiful.
It's really magical.
Julia, asking you about your new album now, and especially your new song and the new film clip we just saw earlier, how did that come about, working with Quentin Aaron?
Oh, it was really random, actually. The director kind of put a call out for, she wanted somebody that was going to look different to me, a visually interesting relationship between two people in love. And Quentin heard about it from his roommate, who was a fan of Angus and my music, and told Quentin he should do it. And Quentin got in contact with us, and that was kind of how it happened. It was pretty random. We met up for lunch one day and we really liked each other. And
wow.
Yeah, so.
He was the guy in Blindside too, the movie, wasn't he?
Yeah.
Great big fella. Now, I was listening to you, hey, big fella, I was listening to you rehearse before. You talk about California. California gets a really good run. California Girls, California Dream and Hotel California.
Uh-huh.
We've been talking about California in music for years. Is it because it's got 5 syllables and it just fits in with lyrics?
It actually is very good.
Like, you don't probably write about Dubbo or...
Wollongong.
Wollongong.
I want to live with you.
Well, that's got a lot of syllables.
Actually, yeah, it could work. I'll think about that for the next album.
Seriously, though. Well, that was a bit serious. California, it's a special place, isn't it?
It is special. It's kind of, I don't know, there's something magical about it. It feels like that coastal drive from LA up to San Francisco and the ocean, and I don't know, anything is possible. And certainly my experience of being there, I fall in love a lot, and it's a place that I fell in love with, and
Can I ask you, Julia, about sort of the content of the lyrics as well? It seems like it's certainly a very philosophical, even existential theme throughout it there. I think previously you were quoted as saying you don't want to worry about what people say about you when you're gone. Is it philosophical for you, the writing process?
Yeah, I think the writing for me is, I don't know, I guess just, particularly I think on this last record, it was more about writing the songs just because it felt like something nice to do, you know. It was really just a way of spending time with myself, and I think that comes up a lot in this business where you're out performing all the time in front of people, that you kind of get to a place where you don't want to be doing it because you want people to like you, or you want people to like your music. You do it because it makes you feel good, and if other people feel good because of it, that's great, but if they don't, it doesn't matter. It comes from a place inside you rather than something that you're looking for outside.
Very profound. Very well said.
Great.
You'll be doing well to match that level of profound thought in sport as well. Well, Julia, you'll be back a little later in the show to perform one of these songs from your new album, Justine, and we're very much looking forward to that.
Thank you
for joining us tonight.
And say good day to our mate Angus,
yes,
too.
I will. I'll be seeing him this weekend for home bake.
Say good day.
He's a good mate of yours now, Brad, isn't he? You and Angus.
We're like that.
You are.
No, I wish.